Hi, so this is Danica and I build WordPress membership sites. And one of the plugins that I use is GamePress. And in this video, I'm gonna show you a specific thing that I'm working on. So example, if you're using the GamePress button functionality to give badge or to give a reward, this is one of an example of your, I'm just gonna zoom in. This is one of the example of your shortcodes. So depending on how you set it up, you should have something like this. Now, there is a trick to how to make this shorter. And I'm gonna show you that. So the way to do it is you could create a custom field and just ask for the ID, because basically that's the only unique thing for this GamePress button, the ID of your reward. Now I created this custom field here and I set it to show on a specific post type, and I'm asking for the button ID. And instead of having this long format, which still works, there's no problem with that, but just in case you want to make it shorter and easier to maybe manage later on, when I created that field, all you need to do now is just enter the button ID. Now in your template, you need to call that field and do some stuff. So example, here on the single post template, the way I did it is at the very bottom there's this dynamic field and I'm pulling that GamePress button. Now when you're using Jet Engine, or I think this also works with advanced custom field, you could do some shortcodes and stuff. So we grab the data. So whatever data you enter here, we grab that and then we wrap it in a shortcode. So this one has the same format really from this one at the bottom. But since we are going to integrate this in the template, it's much easier to update later on. So as you can see here, it's still the GamePress shortcode, but this time we're replacing the ID, which is modulo s or percented s, and that's the value of your field here. Now the nice thing about this, and why I recommend you set it up this way, is example, you wanna change the button name. So instead of just instead of saying collect your badge, you want to change it to something else. And this setup is much easier to manage later on. Also, maybe you want to adjust the delay, because this one has some 2 seconds delay. I think that's 2 seconds. So if you want to adjust that, you could just adjust that in this template and not individually on your page, which is very handy. But again, there's nothing wrong with this. This is just me showing another way to make it more simpler and much easier to update or manage later on by just setting it up this way. So, I hope this video helps. And in another video, I'm going to show you how I created some animation or some indicator that something's going on when they click this collect your badge button. So I'll see you in the next video, and again, if you have any question, feel free to comment that down below, and so that I could maybe cover that in my next videos. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Bye bye.